This video is brought to you by Ageless Geeks.
Kiwabunga dudes and dudettes, this is Anthony, aka BatBomb82, and today I'll be doing a review of the Power Rangers Lightning Collection Dino Charge Black Ranger. Now, taking a look at the front, we can see that the figure is showcased in your standard window box packaging. Turning the box around, we can see a really cool image of the figure in a kind of awkward pose. So with the box out of the way, let's crack this figure open and see what we have inside.
It's morphin' time!
Alright guys, now here is Dino Charge Black Ranger. When did this even happen? This wasn't announced, we weren't shown prototype images, we weren't told about a certain wave including him. He just started popping up in stores earlier this week. And I have him in hand now. We know nothing, so it's pretty crazy that Hasbro just decided to randomly drop this figure out of nowhere. So I'm pretty stoked to have this, as I absolutely love the Dino Charge team, and he looks awesome. Now, if I remember, this is Chase, right? It's been a while since I've seen Dino Charge, so feel free to correct me if I'm wrong and let me know what his real name is. I'm pretty sure it's Chase. But this looks really, really good, man. I love the helmet. I've always loved the Dino Charge helmets. I think they look really cool. Oh, they have that little face shield right there around the mouth. The red eyes looks awesome. The yellow paint. The paint on the helmet looks really nice. That nice, thin, white line going around the entire face shield, along with that yellow, looks awesome. And then the silver and the yellows with the specific Dino emblem right there. The morpher all looks really good. I love this, man. Really great looking figure. I love the shoulder spikes. I've always dug the Dino Charge logo. So, he's pretty much the same thing as you see with the Red Ranger here. Again, the only difference is mostly going to be the paint apps, the emblem right there for the different dino, and then the helmet. Everything else is going to be pretty much the same as far as like sculpt goes and all that. It's really just going to be in the paint, but he's so awesome, man. Really, really digging this guy. Okay, so let's talk his accessories now. So we do get interchangeable hands. We got two gripping hands, one for each side. We also do get like more karate chopping hand for like his right side here. And then we do get a closed fisted hand for his this is his right side. That's his left side. Excuse me. But standard, just the straight peg like that. That worked very, very well. So I do like the way these wrist pegs work. We also do get his blaster here, which is really nice. So you can get that in his, preferably his right hand, because the fingers are a little more molded with a better trigger finger for the hand, like so. And then we get some black detailing on the outside, not on this side. So it feels a little weird that we don't have like the black stripes and things like that, only on the one side right here, but it still looks really good and it works very well. I do like that. One thing I will note though, you can't hold it out straight because this wrist doesn't hinge up and down. It more goes back and forth like so. So if you extend the arm and the way the hand is posed, it's always going to be kind of at an up angle like that. So that's a little weird. I wish we could be hinged up and down like that. So it is what it is, man. I wish that would change a little bit. But we also do get a really cool blast effect. And one thing that I really like about the Lightning Collection is that we can do get blast effects now. And this actually does peg into the little barrels right there, like so, if I can get that on there. And that works very well too. A very nice, clear purple blast with a little swirl there. I think that looks awesome, man. They did a very good job with that. I wonder why we didn't get this effect with the other Dino Charge Rangers. I don't think he did, right? I could be mistaken, but that's a really nice effect. I love that. Fairly gummy plastic, so it works pretty nice. And then we also do get his sword, because the Dino Charge Rangers gotta have that specific sword. Again, I think it looks really nice. The sculpt is beautiful. Same thing that we've seen with the Red Ranger here. No major real difference. It looks like, yeah, it's it's basically the same thing. The yellow might be a little different on the blade for the Black Ranger, but it's initially the same thing, so that works very nice. What I also do like, we could pop this off, and we can have an unhelmeted chase head like so. And I actually think that works very nicely. If I remember, doesn't he wear a cap, in like a backwards cap or something? I can't remember exactly. That would have been cool to have that, but still, this looks awesome. Why would he wear a cap under his helmet? That would make no sense. But anyways, still, I think this looks really, really cool, man. That's a very, very nice looking face sculpt. Alright, so now let's run down his articulation. If you have pretty much any of the Lightning Collection figures, you know what you're going to get. Head's on a ball joint. You're mostly going to get up and down with that disc hinge in there as well, and left and right. So a little bit of head wobbling. Arms can go full 360 on this side, even with the shoulder pad up out that far. We do get butterfly joints, rotation at the bicep, double jointed elbows, rotation at the wrist, as well as a hinge at the wrist. We get a double ball peg in the midsection that rolls around like so, does turn left and right, pivot side to side, and crunches back and forth, as well as a separate ab crunch that goes, allows him to go all the way forward that far, all the way back that much. A little bit of gapping in there, but it's nothing too terrible. I got hip joints that kick forward that far, back not so much, splits about that far, rotation in the upper thigh, double jointed knee where he can kick himself in his own butt, rotation at the boot, ankles go up, down, and a very good ankle rocker. So overall, I think this is a really good addition to the Lightning Collection. Again, none of us really know anything about this figure. It just started hitting stores one day, and there it was, and now we have him because... why not? Sure, thanks Hasbro for the surprise. It's always really cool to see a surprise Power Ranger on our pegs. I'm loving this figure, man. I love Dino Charge. I love the Lightning Collection. And I think he is definitely a must get. So for a quick size comparison, here he is standing next to a Marvel Legends Deadpool and NECA Batman figures. Also for comparison, here he is standing next to the Lightning Collection Dino Charge Red Ranger and Dino Charge Gold Ranger. And just for fun, here he is with little Lego Bat Bomb. So there it is, guys, my review of the Power Rangers Lightning Collection Dino Charge Black Ranger. Now again, none of us really have a clue where this figure even came from. He just popped up on the shelves. So big shout out to my buddy Daniel for hooking me up. Now this guy is pretty awesome, as I absolutely love the Dino Charge characters and their suits are awesome. This Lightning Collection figure is very well done. I love his weapons, I love his paint apps and sculpt, and I really dig that cool effect piece. And of course that unhelmeted head is pretty well done. I'm really, really digging it. So for a surprise action figure, I am super stoked with it, and I think you'd be awesome in any of your Power Rangers collections. So please comment, like, and subscribe. Stay nerdy, my friends. Peace.
To have you, and so am I. May the power protect you always.